main proposal, the thing that's most exciting about it is the idea, frankly, we can create a whole new industry, an industry that's based on chemical and biological sensors. It'll have very, very important military and commercial applications.
The photonics industry in the U.S. is at a crossroads. We have led the world in developing new photonics technologies which serve our nation's defense, communications, and security needs. But to stay ahead of global competitors, we need a new ecosystem to produce the next generation of integrated photonics devices. This is an historic opportunity to revolutionize the carrying capacity of internet networks so they can transmit more data at faster speeds, enhance medical technology, reduce the cost of sequencing the human genome, and improve battlefield imaging and radar capabilities for national defense. Rochester will draw on historic strengths in optics, imaging, and precision engineering to lead the collaborative coast-to-coast AIM Photonics Initiative.
There are a number of assets that the state of New York can bring to the table, specifically in the Rochester area. There is the strategy of our governor that puts together universities with industries and enables close collaboration. There are the tremendous intellectual assets that the University of Rochester, the Rochester Institute of Technology, as well as SUNY Poly can bring to the table, all within the Rochester area. Last not least, there's a very large number and a very dense cluster of small and medium companies that are very capable and interested in working on one of the key problems for the integrated photonics cluster, and that is assembly and packaging.
The Rochester region also has a strong track record of leveraging federal funding to support advanced manufacturing jobs and innovation in optics, photonics, and imaging. In 2012, Rochester received one of 10 grants from the Advanced Manufacturing Jobs and Innovation Accelerator Challenge to stimulate the growth of optics, photonics, and imaging, or OPI, companies here. 2 years later, it received a National Institute of Standards and Technology Award to develop the roadmap for National Institute for Photonics Manufacturing. Also in 2014, the Rochester Finger Lakes region was designated one of only 12 manufacturing communities by President Barack Obama, specifically for its leading role in precision machining and optics, photonics, and imaging. The AIM Photonics Initiative is a logical next step.
It's going to enable us to address new markets that we're currently not able to participate in.
The 75 optics, photonics, and imaging companies in our region generate over $3 billion in annual sales and employ 17,000 people.
I think one of the interesting things about what's happened in Rochester as Kodak and Xerox have downsized significantly is that so many of the technology people who are at Kodak and Xerox, they're still here. And they have spawned a generation of research and development that goes on in this community that we kind of take for granted, but it's actually quite special here in Rochester.
At the same time that Kodak's Rochester area employment dropped to fewer than 7,000 jobs from 61,000, the community itself gained a net 90,000 jobs. Carestream Health, Rochester Precision Optics, and Optimation are among the companies that have spun off from Kodak or acquired former Kodak units. The growth of these small and medium companies has kept Rochester competitive, says Mike Morris, CEO of RPC Photonics.
There's currently 60 to 80 small and mid-sized optics companies in this region, and it's that kind of infrastructure or ecosystems that enables you to do things very efficiently. That whole supply chain, a majority of it's right here already.
Rochester, like in a very few places in the world, for generations, people have been doing precision optics, photonics, precision metrology. There are very many companies. It's taught in the universities, and it just becomes part of the culture in the region.
The ability to innovate continues as well. The number of patents has more than doubled in the Finger Lakes region since 2005, even as Kodak's share has dwindled. Did you know that Rochester is number one per capita in OPI patents in the nation? Or that 95% of Rochester's OPI patent holders still live here? A highly skilled workforce is sustained by 18 colleges and universities in the Rochester region. The University of Rochester and Rochester Institute of Technology provide undergraduate and graduate education in disciplines that will propel our photonics industry to the next generation of innovation and beyond. However, the industry faces a challenge in finding ways to increase yield to keep costs reasonable.
What I'm hoping from this effort is that will have an interplay between the industrial interests like my own and the university interests, which are more about the physical processes that go on when you're doing this epitaxial growth. In a manufacturing environment, we don't have that luxury. We have to grow many wafers, take the yields we get, and go on. Whereas in universities, you can delve down and figure out what's going on so that you can fix it.
The Institute of Optics at the University of Rochester, the nation's first such institute, has awarded nearly half of all optics degrees in the U.S. The university's faculty conduct cutting-edge research in nanophotonics, quantum optics, terahertz optoelectronics, and free-form optics. At RIT, the initiative will partner with a semiconductor and microsystem fabrication lab and Center for Electronics Manufacturing and Assembly.
Literally in our region, photonics may be the most important industry. Close to $3 billion of activity is generated in the 9 Finger Lakes counties. We're very proud at the University of Rochester of the leadership in, if you will, the development of ideas in this area. But it's not just idea development. The reason we're designated as the headquarters city, quite candidly, is because of our increasing leadership in areas like testing, assembling, and packaging, and sensors.
Rochester's rich industrial and academic base in optics, photonics, and imaging has a long tradition of meeting challenges.
This is a city, Rochester, which has a long history of prowess in big science and accomplishment with corporate development. We have national leadership in optics education, optics patents. Optics graduates are working throughout the country, many of whom are our partners in this project.